A very good morning, class, and welcome back. We are dealing with the chapter number 7, service sector. And in the last video, we talked about the air transport. Today, we shall be talking about the communication channels. The topic of the day is communication channel. We'll see what is the importance of communication, how communication plays an important role in the easy transformation of a business or a trade practice. See, in a very simple, in a layman's term, communication means exchange of words, exchange of ideas from one corner to the other part. It does not have any limitations or any boundaries. Means the person sitting at McCluskey Gunch can have a deal of operation, can have a deal of business to the people who reside in any foreign country, but example for Scotland, let's say America, anywhere he can communicate and have a deal of the business, that is over the phone or the all other means of communication channels are there. So, as far as types of communications are concerned, the oldest means of communication is postal services. Then on we came to the telecommunication. Telecommunication, which includes the today's uses of mobile phones and data services. With the event of the Jio services, this communication has reached the masses. Now every hand has a set, a cell phone. That means they have become a part of the communication channel. So I'll just go through how communication helps in the easy trade practices, or what are the benefits that it gives for the easy transformation of a business over different modes of communication channels. So just read through and I'll explain you the point wherein the data are mentioned, when was it established and what was its need, how did it transform itself with the current scenario or with the current need. A developed communication network is an essential requirement of modern times. If today you want to start your venture, start your business, the one thing that you need to update is your communication channel. How are you going to connect with your customers? That plays a pivot role over here, that plays an important role. That what mode you are going to choose for the communication process. It comprises post and telegraph, telecommunication system, broadcasting, television and information services. So these are types of communication channels which is available in our country, which we use generally in order to have a trade practice, in order to have a trade from one country to other country or within the boundary of the country. It helps to bring buyers and sellers together and thus helps to accelerate the growth of the economy. See, we are talking about the buyers and sellers and trade practices. That means we are concerned with the economic services only. How the economy runs or what are the economical aspects of the telecommunication that we are talking about. Apart from these, there are major other events or achievements which telecommunications have achieved. But being a part of the economics group or economic student, we will only focus on the trade practices, that is buying and selling process. Buying and selling process or buying and selling of goods over the internet services, over the communication channel is what the communication is all about for us. Besides public administration, national defense and even our personal life, all call for efficient means of communication. See, these are the areas where the means of communications are used. But we will talk about the trade and trade practices or import-export or buying and selling process. We shall now make a review of the progress of various means of communication in India. How has it grown over the time that we see? The first one is postal services. It is the oldest means of communication in India as far as our country is concerned. It is the oldest means. Postal services or post offices are the oldest means of communication channel over here. It has made a remarkable progress during the planning period. Now, planning period is basically, it began from the year 1951 when first 5-year plans were passed on. Now it has been replaced by Niti Aayog, Planning Commission, whose head or whose chairperson used to be the Prime Minister. It is replaced by Niti Aayog, National Institution for Transforming India. It is called as Niti Aayog, N-I-T-I. Niti Aayog, it's a government body which actually formulates plans and policies on year-to-year basis or on a financial year basis. The full form of NITI is National Institutions for National Institution for Transforming India. National Institutions for Transforming India. The head of this is, or the chairperson of NITI Aayog is the Prime Minister. So, postal services introduced in the year 1837, before independence, 110 years before independence, this services were established. Means it shows that the British were using this means, this mode of communication for the easy flow of trade practices or buying and selling of goods. First postal stamp was issued in 1852. Postal stamp we are talking about 1852, and postal department was set up in 1854. Railway mail service and air mail service were started in 1907 and 1911. Respectively. In 1950-51, there were 36,094 post offices, and the number has now gone up to 155,516, of which 90% of the post offices are in the rural sector. See, basically, a statement that you remember, that this was a statement of the first Prime Minister of the country, Jawaharlal Nehru. He said that if you control, if you look after the rural population where the heart of the India resides, that means you have taken care of the urban areas. So basically, whenever the government scheme was established in the early times, it basically took care of the rural sector, or it began from the rural sector, just to have a better control, just to have a better placement of the rural population, so that they do not migrate or their needs are fulfilled and they reside there in their own region, and the growth sector keeps on moving. So was the case with the postal services. 90% of the post offices were set up in the rural sector only. On an average, a post office serves an area of 21.10 square kilometers and a population of 6,623. So these are the data which just you need to keep in mind. What you need to put up in postal services are, how was postal services set up, which year, and what is the importance of this service, how it has come from the British time to the today's time, how it has made a progress, that you can add. The long term objective of the Department of Postal Service is to locate a post office within 3 kilometers of every village and to provide the facility of a letterbox and letterbox in every village with a population of 500, which the figure has substantially changed now, but as far as your syllabus is concerned, you will keep this data only in your mind. Our postal network is the largest in the world. This is a remarkable line, that this is the largest network in the world. Since we are very, we began from very early day, that is why we are the leading one, or we are the largest network provider of this service throughout the world. At present, almost all villages and towns in India have daily postal services. Nearly 6 lakh people are employed in post and telegraph department. To improve the quality of services, and inland night air mail service has been introduced. Another scheme called was introduced in 1973. Quick mail services basically began in the year 1973, wherein the mails were transferred to the concerned persons or concerned departments in a very less span of time, in a very short span of time. That was through air means of communication. So whatever was an urgent one, an emergency one, those would be transferred to the concerned place or concerned department within no span of time. And that was done through air transport. This covers all important cities of India. To handle the growing volume of mail, postal index number was introduced in 1972. See, as a result, when it began in the year 1837, from 1972, the government felt that there is a lot of demand and created in the market for postal services. So it was creating a heavy network or a heavy traffic of the postal services. So just to ease the process, the government came up with the idea of PIN number, that is postal index number. So whichever location you want to drop your postal badge, you just need to put down the PIN number. Just to ease the process of the communication service, this was done in the year 1972. In recent years, special emphasis has been given to extend the postal services in the backward areas. Now the backward areas are also taken in. Now backward areas are those areas wherein basically the remote part of the country wherein no mode of communication is available. Neither the different modes of transporting channels are available, nor these telecommunications are available. So in order to just make them a part of the system, the government has been making strategic effect so that they can cover themselves into the main ambit of the economy. Next is telecommunication, the one that we are using, with the blessings of one that we are connected today. In the age of Corona or in the times of Corona, we are still able to communicate with each other, we are still able to contact with each other. It is all due to the blessings of this telecommunication channel. So the telephone system has been upgraded technologically. We are upgraded technologically now, means technologically we have been advanced one, and day by day a lot of improvements are done which have been upgraded just to ease our life policies or life cycles. Electronic exchange, digital telephone and cordless instruments have been introduced. Subscriber trunk dialing, that is STD, facility has been introduced and is now available more than 825 stations. Yeah, you must be hearing that I need to make a STD call or an ISD call. Before it was very prevalent, now since there is no as such barrier over here with the event of the Jio, when the Jio was gone, all the barriers were removed. And we rarely say that STD calls have to be made. Instead we say we have to make a call for a simple note only. Because the barriers have been removed, we do not know what is STD, ISD and all. Okay, IFD is basically the international one. The international subscriber dialing is the ISD one. And STD is subscriber trunk dialing, that is the in the local or in the domestic regions only. Fax, facsimile. Fax services has been introduced to enable immediate transmission of whole page. See, fax services are also there. Through fax you can send the letter to the concerned person, some images or some sort of documents which are very essential without any delay that should be sent to the concerned office. For that purpose we use the fax system or facsimile system. Okay, there is a number for it, fax number through which we send it to different parts within or outside the country. This is done with the help of fax machine, which is attached to a telephone line. Fax is basically with the help of, it is type of telephone service only. Okay, but there is a difference between telephone service and fax service. In fax service, we are able to transfer some sort of pages. Like for example, if I want to send a document of this postal services, this is page number 112. If I wish to send you, I will note down your fax number and I will send it to the fax. Okay, the moment I send, you will receive the same page, like a Xerox part, and you will have a copy of it. Okay, that pages will come out, and the person who is the other side, he will give you a printout of the same manual. The Government of India has announced a new internet service is the latest addition to the communication technology. See, this is the latest addition which we all are part of it now, and we know how easy it has become with the event of the internet technology, with the event of internet services, how our work has become easier now. Anything or everything that we are doing today is somewhere down the line is a part of internet services only. So internet services cannot be skipped, or this mode has made the growth of the economy on a very vector basis. It refers to a collection of thousands of computers, business and millions of people throughout the world linked together in a service called World Wide Web, WWW, World Wide Web. Means the world has become a global village. This is the tagline that we use. The world has become a global village. How? Everything can be, or everyone can be connected to one node, that is internet services. No matter in which area, in which part you reside, which part of the world, which part of the country, not which part of the world you reside, that does not matter. Means the barriers have been removed. No barriers now, no obstacles now. We are on an easy basis, on a free flow basis, we can communicate with each other. We can see each other, we can know the status of each other, whether he or she is and what he or she is doing, that we can do. So this is the blessing of modern era. The Government of India has announced in its new telecommunications policy in the year 1999, under which national long distance service has been opened to private sector with effect from August 13, 2000. Means earlier to this, prior to this, all the telecommunication channels were linked to BSNL only. It was VSNL, Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited. But with the event of private sector entering into this sector, telecommunication sector, this sector has actually flourished growth, or have seen a marvelous growth. All the private companies were given a permission or a license to be a part of the competition to BSNL, which actually improved the services, and the network and the people who were connected, they have gone up in a drastic way. There is a marvelous increase in this number of people who participated in the communication channel, have grown up, have gone at a very high level compared to what the BSNL had. The monopoly is when one person rules over everything, that is called monopoly. So VSNL had a monopoly over the telecommunication channel. But after 13th August 2000, it was opened for every private owner. So it became a respective market for all the persons who had the power to enter into this sector. They actually grew the business, they actually grew the people, and the consumer space were won, and they became a part of the telecommunication channel. The monopoly of Videsh Sanchar Limited or BSNL over international long distance service was ended, and BSNL has been privatized. The private sector entered along with BSNL. BSNL was a government one, but it was privatized, and all other private individuals were asked to participate in. So they were given a free hand, free policy from the government side, that they can be a part of the telecommunication channel. They can give their services if they are able and willing to. The direction of policies in the telecom sector are driven by this new policy, that is TRAI, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. TRAI is the body who looks after, who manages all the rules and regulations with regards to the telecommunication. Like I told you, the NHAI, National Highway Authority of India, looks after the road management. AAI, Airport Authority of India, looks after the airport airways or air communication. Same way, the TRAI, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, looks after the policies planning, management, and the framework of the telecommunication channel. All the rules and regulations are made by the TRAI. TRAI is a government recognized body which is accepted by the government of India, and it looks after all the matters. The Indian telecom sector has now made a rapid progress during the last few years regarding the several reforms and initiatives undertaken by the Department of Telecommunications. Now, Indian telecom sector has grown. Okay, that is what I am telling you, that it has made a remarkable progress in the recent years. Means after the privatization was done, or after the licenses were given to the private persons, it has made a tremendous progress. India now has the second largest network in the world, next only to China. So we are the second service, in the world to provide telecom services or internet services in the world ranking. We are the second one, China is the first. India crossed the landmark of 1 million telecom subscribers in the year 2015-16, and the total subscriber now stands at 1195.0 million as of 31st March 2017. Out of this, 501.8 million concentrates are in rural and 693.2 million urban areas. So this distribution, the rural and urban, is quite remarkable. There is not big difference between the rural and urban connectivity. Means people in the rural areas are also welcoming the step of the government of India, and they are being a part of the telecommunication channel, which is a fruitful step for the growth of the economy. So with the introduction of this of the new entrant Reliance Jio Infocom, that is Reliance Jio Infocom RIL Limited, on 5th September 2016, the competition extended from cheaper calls to cheaper data. Prior to the entrance of Jio, when the Jio was not established in the year 2016, it came in 5th September 2016, the date on the Teachers' Day, it is that is the day when the Jio entered into the market. So prior to this, everything was costly. Either it is a domestic call, international call, all very costly one, or the internet services. Airtel used to be the one that was ruling the market at that time. So it had a very costly tariffs and all, the vouchers and all were very costly one. But when Jio entered the market, it actually destroyed all the competition. And it had its own stake, and the monopoly was again ruled by the Jio subscribers or the Jio Infocoms. That means the people got converted from other networks to the Jio due to the type of network, type of subscribers that launched, you know, type of initiative or the packages that it came into the market. So we are in the modern era, we are blessed to have such facilities wherein we can communicate with the different people throughout the world. The world is now open for us, and the communication channel helps us not only to do our daily activities, but it actually helps in the growth of the economy. If you are engaged in a business line, whatever business you do, you get a benefit of these services. With this, I will stop over here, and from tomorrow onwards, from the next video onwards, we shall start with the banking channels, how banking plays a major role in the trade and services. Thank you, class.